Thank you. Well, good evening, everybody, and welcome to the Christmas Eve service at Unity Temple on the Plaza. This is the first in many ways. There are people all over the world watching this service along with you right now in this moment. And there are also people in every state in the Union that tune into our services. So we welcome all of you, wherever you are, to this special service. Tonight we have a wonderful surprise for you. The music is provided by Steve Perry and the Unity Octet, along with Robert Farrago, Millie Edwards, and Jerome Johnson. So please enjoy this service and join with me in this opening prayer. Please say this with me if you choose. We offer this Christmas Eve prayer with the hope there will be food for the hungry, healing for the sick, compassion for the less fortunate, and safety and comfort for all. With gratitude in our hearts, we sing a song of hope and renewal. We pray with joy in our hearts and faith in our God. With love, we forgive any resentments we hold, and with love, we affirm peace on earth and goodwill to all.
Ventris tuus. and your baby boy would one day walk on water. Mary, did you know that your baby boy would save our sons and daughters? Did you know that your baby boy has come to make it new? This child that you delivered would soon deliver you. Mary, did you know that your baby boy would give sight to a blind man? Mary, did you know that your baby boy would calm a storm with his hand? Did you know that your baby boy has walked where angels cry? When you kiss your sleeping baby, you kiss the face of God. Mary, did you know? The blind will see, the deaf will hear, the dead will live again. The lame will leap, the dumb will speak, the praises of the Lamb. Mary, did you know that your baby boy is Lord of all creation? Mary, did you know that your baby boy would one day rule the nation? Did you know that your baby boy is heaven's perfect lamb? That sleeping child you're holding is the great I Am. Mary, did you know he's the great I Am? Mary, did you know? Mary, did you know?
The story I'm about to share with you is about an event that took place well over 2,000 years ago. It is a story that can stir within our minds and our hearts inspiration, wonder, and awe. It's a story about a message and a messenger that changed the course of history and still changes our world today. Join with me as we share the Christmas story. The story begins with a young woman who was chosen by God to bring forth a great miracle, the birth of a child named Jesus. As Jesus matured into a young man, he awakened to a higher consciousness, to a spiritual dimension of mind that provided him with the vision, insight, and wisdom to experience life in a more meaningful, joyful, and loving way. Jesus never claimed to be special or better than others. He didn't claim to be an exception, but rather he came forth as an example for how everybody could experience life. Jesus brought to all humanity the truth about our divine nature, known to us this day as the Christ consciousness.
Rejoice,
our story begins. God sent an angel named Gabriel to visit a young woman named Mary, who was engaged to a man named Joseph in a town called Nazareth of Galilee. When the angel appeared to Mary, she was frightened at first, but the angel said, "Don't be afraid. I'm not here to harm you in any way." The angel went on to tell Mary that God had chosen her to give birth to a son who would be named Jesus. "He will do great things," said the angel, "and bring to the world greater measures of hope, peace, joy, and love." Many months passed when Emperor Augustus put forth a decree that ordered all men to return to their city of birth and register. Joseph and Mary traveled to Bethlehem, the town where Joseph was born. It was a long and exhausting trip. When they got there, the town was very crowded. They tried to get a room at an inn, but every place was booked up. Every place they went, they were turned away. There's not a single room to be had. Finally, Mary and Joseph found a place to stay, but it was in a stable where animals were kept, and that is where Jesus was born. They wrapped their baby in many blankets and laid him in a manger that was filled with hay.
What child is this who laid to rest on Mary's lovely
Far from the stable, there were shepherds living in a field, keeping watch over their sheep. At the exact moment Jesus was born, an angel, surrounded by a brilliant light, appeared before the shepherds to bring them good news. The angel said to the shepherds, "I bring you a message of great joy. On this day, a Savior, Christ the Lord, has been born. You'll find the child not far from here, lying in a manger." Suddenly, many angels came down from heaven, and they began to sing the most beautiful music ever heard that drifted through the dark blue sky to every place on the earth. Glory be to God in the highest, they sang. Peace on earth, goodwill to all. Had left, the shepherds hurried to Bethlehem, where they found the baby Jesus, and they knelt down before him. A long distance away, three wise men saw a brilliant light in the sky. It was a great shining star, and they knew it meant something very special had happened. So they got on their camels and followed the star to Bethlehem. The baby Jesus, they too fell to their knees and praised him with gifts of gold, frankincense, and myrrh. Mary, Joseph, the shepherds, and the wise men all gathered around the little child lying in a manger, and their hearts were filled with adoration and praise.
Oh, come, let us
like the light from the bright and shining star radiated down on everybody everywhere the night Jesus was born. As Jesus grew into a young man, the message he brought to the world was like a light that radiated out to people everywhere, filling hearts and minds with hope, peace, love, and joy. On this day and every day, may we remember to affirm and give thanks for the spiritual gifts Jesus awakened us to. His words of enlightenment that make disappear the dark in us, the inner strength that makes disappear the weak in us, the healing that mends our emotional hurt, the hope that raises us from despair, the peace that overcomes conflict, the faith that dispels all worries and fears, and the love that makes disappear any sense of separation between ourselves and God. For all of this, we say thank you and amen in the name of Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Joy to the world.
In a moment, we'll be lighting our candles. The candle lighting ceremony is symbolic of the one presence in the universe, our God, my God, your God, and each and every one of us. We light the candle off the God box, which represents God, the Almighty Creator. The fire is the same for all of us. The candles are similar, but in that moment, we come together and realize the oneness between us.
The stars are brightly shining. It is the night of our dear Savior's birth. Long lay the world in sin and error pining, till he appeared and the soul felt its worth. A thrill of hope the weary world rejoices, for yonder breaks a new and glorious morn. Glory.
We're now going to light our candles. And once again, remember the symbolism of this. It's that we are united, we are together, we support each other, we love each other. We all come from the same source. We're all living a similar life here on earth. So prepare to light your candle. Our Christmas Eve candlelight service. I hope you enjoyed it as much as I did. It was great being with you at this time. If you or others would like to watch this service, it'll be made available to you anytime after 8 o'clock this evening. After that, you can watch it anytime, night or day. Just go to unitytemple.com and there'll be a thing to click on. Now then, we close with our prayer for protection for everybody everywhere. The light of God does surround us. The love of God enfolds us. The power of God protects us, and the presence of God watches over us. Wherever we are, God is, and all is well. Good night now. Merry Christmas, and a Happy New Year.
Amen. Mm-hmm.